Very good morning, class 9-3. By the time you all were joining, I'm still joining. See, I was writing on the board the points of the chapter, the fun we have. So, as you all know, that we have completed our syllabus. Fine. So, what we are supposed to do? Revision only. And you will be preparing for revision tests also. The earlier we used to conduct 2 or 3 revision tests. Fine, that we will tell you later. Dividing the whole syllabus in 2 parts. Yeah, so we are going to start the revision of literature part first. Literature is carrying the highest weightage in your paper, so you cannot, you know, take it casually. And how you are going to prepare for exams? Rather than cramming the answers, now thorough knowledge will be tested. And how you can get thorough knowledge or the detailed knowledge on the topic? By reading the chapter. Fine, so for your convenience, I have made some points, fine, written some points that you can note down in your revision notebooks or rough notebooks, so that during exam it will be easier for you to go through. But whenever you will be preparing for exam or appearing in revision test, what you will do, you will read the chapter only. Yeah, reading is must. And reading with understanding is must. Yes, girls, fine. Reading for the sake of reading will not help you here. Because you can get any MCQ, any objective question based from any nook and corner of the chapter. If you have read thoroughly with understanding, only then you can get full marks. It is easier to get full marks in objective paper, you all know that subject. This is a golden opportunity for you all, but don't take it casually. I can do it in that way. MCQs will be very tough. So prepare accordingly. So chapter we are going to start today. You know, I just forgot to get the mic today. Was I audible to you all? Yes, children? Am I audible? Earlier also, Gagandeep, my voice was clear. Pehle aa rahi thi awaaz sabko. Fine. So I forgot to wear the mic today. Okay, let's continue. Okay, Raghav, thank you for sending the feedback. Fine. So we're going to start with chapter number 1, the fun they had, which we completed many days ago. Fine. So it is a revision only. Let's go through all the points. Fine. And I'll be highlighting. You have the colored chalk now. So all the characters I'm going to highlight. So firstly, I'm going to highlight the main characters, Tommy, Margie. Fine. Tommy and Margie are the protagonist. Both of them are the main characters which I have highlighted here. And let me tell you about the theme of the this chapter. So this theme is this story unfolds about the you can say future schools. I already told you that never ever we imagined that we will be sitting at home and we will be attending our classes. Fine. And your chapter is based on that only. It is set in future period when there will be no human teachers, only mechanical teachers will be teaching to all the students. There will be no building called school. Fine. In future, and children will be sitting in one of the rooms in their houses, and that is the school itself, carrying one big screen in front of them and putting assignments in the assignment slot. Fine. Submitting your homework. These days also you're doing the same thing, sending the PDFs only. So this story was set in future, but it has happened now only with us. But the main point is your human teachers are still teaching you. The technology has not replaced teachers. In this chapter, the theme is about that picture of future schools where the mechanical teacher teaches to all the children. Clear? So, and students will learn only from the e-books. They do not have any book. So this story is set in future only. Margie and Tommy, they are two such children, those who have never ever gone to any physical school or where a building is there known as school, and they have not, you know, received their education from any human teacher. So how the story starts, let me tell you. There are more points, but firstly, I'll be just discussing these. Tommy finds a real paper book from the attic. So story starts when Tommy, he is searching for something, and in the attic where all things were kept, suddenly he finds a book, and it was a real book, paper book. And when he finds it, he was not that surprised, because from his grandfather he has already gained the knowledge about such books and such schools, so he was aware about it. Clear? So when he finds a real book, that real book was about the schools of many centuries ago. So what sort of schools were there? Many years ago, there were buildings, there were human beings, and children of same age would go to that particular class and attend lectures, right, in that school. So Tommy finds a book in which this is written. He thinks, but according to Tommy, TV screens are much better. Why? Because he says that these words are very stagnant. They do not move. Firstly, you have to turn on the pages, fine. And after reading, the book is waste for you. But when it is like in the form of e-books, you can carry thousands of books, fine, in the memory slot of your computer. So he finds carrying those e-books is easier. So that's why for him, TV screens are better. Then Margi, she hates school and does not understand why the book was written about schools. So when Margi sees that book, she was amazed, she was shocked, surprised that what sort of a book. She had never ever seen a paper book in her entire lifetime. So then Tommy helps her in getting the information. He tells her about the previous era schools. And Margi hates the school. Which school she hates? The schools many centuries ago, or the present technical schools where only screens are teaching them? She thinks that school means mechanical teacher only, the way she attends class in her class. Robo gives the assignment. There is no human teacher, only a software is there to teach them. So she hates this concept. She thought when Tommy tells her that I found a book, which is a paper book, and it is about schools, she thought that this is about our schools, those mechanical teachers and TV screens. But she was not aware that schools, which is written in that book, they are about real schools in the buildings and all, fine, where all the children would learn together. So Tommy told Margi about the real school. So he tells Margi that you are just perceiving wrong. I'm not talking about the present day schools. I'm talking about the schools where our grandfather or grandparents used to go. He tells her that there were huge buildings, children of same age group, they would visit, fine, they would sit together and learn together. And to all the queries, they could receive answers. Fine, Unaisa, you're very talkative. What happened? When, you know, you do not listen, that link is broken then. Then after that, Margi is surprised. After knowing, she becomes so surprised that how come a real man would teach the children in the schools, and what sort of schools they were, how they used to enjoy, fine, everything. When she learns, she was quite surprised. Is that okay, beta? Clear to all of you? Send me your feedback by sending the thumbs up. 20 students have joined only. See, I kept on putting messages also that it is compulsory to attend classes from home. Otherwise, we're going to, you know, stop putting the videos on YouTube. Then you will realize. You sit at home and you think that, okay, videos will be there, and you do not attend your class then. 8 students in the class and 20 here. 28 means out of 46, 28 are there. What about others? I'll be putting the names in the groups also. So all these points are written, beta. Let's continue to next point now. So write down. Tommy tells, rather than writing, I'm now dictating to you. Write down some more points, beta. Tommy tells Margi that teachers did not live in the house. Tommy tells Margi that teachers did not live in the house and kids used to go, kids would go, likh lo, kids would go to a special building to learn. Kids would go to a special building to learn. Then, beta, we have another concept. Margie has problems about learning geography from her mechanical teacher. Margie has problems about learning geography from her mechanical teacher. Next point. County inspector visits her house. County, C-O-U-N-T-Y. County inspector, this is another character, so you must know. Tommy is there, Margie is there. Then we have county inspector. Yes, Divya, tell me, who is county inspector? Yes, when any problem was there with the mechanical teacher, he would visit and fix the problems. Yes, you can sit. So, county inspector visits her house. Next point is, Margie's mother, next character, Margie's mother, Mrs. Johns, J-O-N-E-S. बस यही करेक्टर्स हैं इसमें. फाइन. मार्गीज मदर मिसेस जॉन्स, जे ओ एन एस. इज वरीड अबाउट मार्गीज लर्निंग. वरीड अबाउट मार्गीज लर्निंग. Next point, the county inspector. The county inspector tells that Margie's progress is satisfactory. County inspector tells that Margie's performance or progress, beta. Margie's progress is satisfactory. This is the time to join the class. And then they say ki hamari attendance kyun nahi lagi. Or network issues, they say. They just forget to join the class, I guess. Rishikesh of 90, kindly beta, join well in time. Otherwise, no attendance will be marked. Fine, so county inspector says that Margie's progress is satisfactory. Mrs. Johns believes that, next point, Mrs. Johns believes that each teacher has to be fitted. Mrs. Johns believes that each teacher has to be fitted, F-I-T-T-E-D, has to be fitted to each child's mind. Child apostrophes. Each child's mind. Next point. Mrs. Johns calls Margie. Mrs. Johns calls Margie and tells her that. Mrs. Johns calls Margie and tells her that it is time to go to school. It is time to go to school. Next point. Bas do points rahe hain beta, bear with me. The school room is next to Margie's bedroom. The school room is next to Margie's bedroom. Fine. If you get a question about the school room, where is the school room? Next to Margie's bedroom only. This is not the same room as a bedroom. She has a different bedroom and she has different school room. The school room is next to Margie's bedroom. Full stop. The mechanical teacher, next point, the mechanical teacher asks for Margie's home assignment. The mechanical teacher asks for, A-S-K-S, asks for Margie's homework. Margie likhiye post office. Margie's homework, full stop. Last point. Margie thinks about the time. Margie thinks about the time when teachers were people. When teachers were people and students had real fun in those schools. Margie thinks about a time when teachers were people and students had real fun in those schools. Clear? Yahan pe chapter aapka end ho jata hai. And she started thinking when her mother calls her that go and sit in your school. Where was the school room? Adjoining her bedroom. She sits there. Mechanical teacher gives the assignment, asks her to submit the homework. And Margie hates doing homework. Fine? And when she had to assign, she had to submit it. She started thinking about the old kind of schools where human beings were teachers and there was no such kind of thing. So that's why she says that what kind of fun they had. Fine? Ki kaise wo maze se padhte the wo bacche. The fun they had. They means children of previous era. Clear? Previous centuries. So now she is in future, fine? Not in future, she is in present time. But for us, this is about future schools. Ki aisa hoega future hamara, clear? So that's why the name of the chapter is The Fun They Had. Means people of previous era who used to go to buildings to study. That was real fun when you were interacting. Abab kyun school aa rahe ho, most of you? Because you feel... Wait, Aryan. Aryan of this class. I have changed the settings, fine. So nobody can, you know, put any message over here. This is not the platform for your conversations. Clear? Why are you coming to school? Because at home, sometimes you feel bored. You have no interactions. You cannot talk to your friends. You cannot, when you see them, whether you're not talking that much, though you are socially, you know, sitting alone, so maintaining social distancing, but even then you feel good. Clear? So let's do the question answers based on this chapter now. Yes, tell me. I have not disclosed you better the age of Tommy and Margie. Now you have to tell me, okay? I'll be asking you a question. You will raise your hand. Margie is dash years old. MCQs we are going to do. Likhna hai to likh lo, sunna hai to sun lo. That is up to you. Margie is dash years old. 9, 10, 11, 12. Yes, Dipkirti. 11. Yes, right answer. Dipkirti has given right answer. Margie is 11 years old. Next question is Tommy is dash years old. 11, 12, 13, 14. Yes, Soumya. Yes, next question is Tommy is 13 years old. Fine. I'll be giving questions to the online students also. Firstly, my preference goes to those who are sitting here. Third one is very easy one. I'm asking, what subjects did Margi and Tommy? What subjects did Margi learn? Option A, geography and maths. Dhyan se sunna. Option B, geography and history. Option C, history and maths. And option D, all of the above. सुना है आपने लास्ट वो है? ओके चिल्ड्रन सिटिंग एट होम यू कैन आंसर दिस यू कैन रेज योर हैंड. नोबडी हैज लिसन टू दिस. शैल आई रिपीट? यस दिव्या व्हाट इज द आंसर? यस आंसर इज ज्योग्राफी एंड मैथमेटिक्स. सो यू बिकेम लेट रियांशिका. फाइन दिव्या हैज गिवन द आंसर. ओके next question is beta you can note down for your practice also. I would not throw it away. This is a dialogue. Fine. I would not throw it away. Who says these words? Mrs. Jones, Margi, Tommy, the county inspector. Raise your hand. I would not throw it away. You know the answer? Yes. When did she say this? Yes, fine. So Titiksha already give answer is given by? Yes, Jasleen has given the answer. Very good, beta. Margi says these words. I would not throw it away. What does it refer to here? Everybody knows? It refers to the book. It can be anything. It was a book, machine, paper. So you should know what she's talking about. The paper book was compared with dash. The paper book was compared with dash. Telebook, e-book, other paper books, old books. Yes. E-book. Yes, Kirti, what do you say? Telebook. So, Titiksha and Bhavansh. Yes, Bhavansh, you can speak, beta.
Ma'am, old book. Ma'am, e-book.
E-book, you are saying. Titiksha, what is your answer, beta?
Ma'am, telebook.
This is the correct answer. I told you, maine pehle easy poocha aapse. एग्जाम में ऐसे ही होने वाला है. वेरी इजी ऑल्सो. देन यू गॉट स्टक टू टू ऑप्शंस. अब कुछ बच्चे कह रहे हैं ई बुक्स इज द आंसर. ई बुक्स रॉन्ग नहीं है. देन टेली बुक्स इज द आंसर. वो भी रॉन्ग नहीं है. बोथ आर करेक्ट. बट यू हैव टू सी व्हाट वाज रिटन इन द चैप्टर. क्लियर? दैट्स व्हाई योर थॉरो नॉलेज विल बी टेस्टेड. आई एम टेलिंग यू दिस इज द एग्जाम्पल आई सेट इन फ्रंट ऑफ यू. सो टेली बुक्स इज द आंसर. बट बिकॉज दिस इज मेंशन इन द बुक जो भी वर्ड उन्होंने यूज किए दैट इज द करेक्ट आंसर. तो आपको क्या करना है अभी? यू हैव टू रीड द चैप्टर. आज घर जाके एवरीबडी विल रीड दिस. दो वी हैव रिवाइज्ड हियर बट ऑल द पॉइंट 70% कवर हो गए होंगे. 30% फिर रह गए होंगे. तो यू हैव टू रीड द चैप्टर थॉरली. The county inspector said Margi's performance was dash. Poor, great, average, satisfactory. Unaisa. Yes, satisfactory is the right answer. Clear? Again, this is the easiest one. What was a great waste according to Tommy? Option A, telebooks. Option B, all e-books. Option C, old printed book. Option D, none of the above. Yes, anybody at home? Yes, Karanveer Singh, beta, you can speak.
Old printed books.
Yes, correct answer. Well done, Karanveer. So bell is gone. Have a nice day and prepare well for the exams, beta. And send your notebooks for final checking.